house, bro. Yo, from the top of the hill, the sun stares, but those in the dungeons don't even know it's there. The crops at abundance, oh so prepared. The population plummets when warfare's there. But of course I'm aware, the more trees bear, the less we reflect the source of clean air. What if it isn't there at all? No trees to breathe, no choice to leave, and not a single key. It's simple to me, the soul grows distant. The further from society, more so resistant. So if you gotta die when you locked up in prison, the corpse is forgotten, the soul stays with it. The whole day's missing, reality diminishes, taking you with it. Not even the devil himself visits. I see that you living, though this isn't religious. The soul beholds unlimited vividness within it. So the cell stays cold with frozen hinges. Once your trip to hell gets there, you'll go and miss it. Or even worse, what if heaven actually had you enlisted? That's a catastrophe and nobody should risk it. So many did it, they went and sold their soul for cheap. It's more valuable once you're in an infinite sleep. A minute passes, 1, 2, 3,000 days after. Disaster proves your soul's captured, stuck in a limbo with no way to get no place. These fucking ethereal chains is pitiful, misery's unforgettable. There's not a way to rip away from the interval, the centerfold of heaven and hell. If you glance up, the clouds fulfill the emptiness where forever they dwell. But if you glance down, all you hear is man down, followed by fuck it, followed by finish him. In the depths of the coffin, nobody comes in, just the soul resulted from death in the dungeon. Make no less of an assumption, eternity with nothing might be worse than the dungeon within the oven. In the depths of the coffin, nobody comes in, just the soul resulted from death in the dungeon. Make no less of an assumption, eternity with nothing might be worse than the dungeon within the oven.
Y'all might want to take that advice, if you even understood the advice, that is.